Hello, beautiful Pisces. Welcome to the channel. This is Irish Donna Tarot, and my name is Donna Wilder-Hart. Let's get started with your abundance and life path reading. Pisces, as we open your reading, your absolute money, abundance, and life path reading, we have this beautiful card that shows that you currently are endowed with invisible wings, which allow you to swiftly bring your circumstances into alignment with your highest purpose. This is a sign that the waiting that you've, you know, you whatever you've been waiting for, the time is over, the hard work has paid off, and it will no longer be beyond the scope of your wishes. Now you have the ability to reach for the stars and find one with your name on it. Spread your wings and fly, Pisces. The next card, this I call this the card of magic. In every reading, we have a card that's magic. And this is the Oh Sunny Day. And it shows a woman with a very dainty umbrella, and there are three little ladybugs on the mushroom. So it's really speaking about it's a brand new day. Embrace new beginnings and let the worries and regrets of yesterday just pass away. Don't allow them to linger today. All the moments of this day are brand new, never seen before or since. So you have the power to make good things happen, and you can make today your lucky day. Wow, I have more good, your reading is packed with good news this month. The guardian, the fire guardian says, ignite your passions. Okay, so it's a new day. The way you manifest this month, Pisces, is really through prayer. Now, prayer is not something that I'm going to define for you. What it really tells us is that it's very important to be of service to spirit, to remind us of the importance to get quiet, to get low, to get humble and soft, bow and touch the ground as your heart lifts to the sky. It might be an uncomfortable time, but nothing else really will do. So it's important to have gratitude. And as a natural result of gratitude, it really is to simply surrender to spirit and let spirit allow you to see things from a higher perspective, to have a positive attitude, and to know that you can be brave and passionate at this time. Now, Pisces, we're going to take a look at your astrology through the tarot cards, because this is how we find your path as well as your abundance. So you have, Pisces, your first house is your body, yourself, the way you present yourself, and your seventh house is so you're Pisces, and this is Virgo, your seventh house. So you have a partner who is in a time of completion, Pisces. Your partner is getting ready to move from one very successful cycle to another very successful cycle. This beautiful Virgo energy really says what a good partner you are, that you are really doing your share of the work, you're really stepping in day to day, that this is another way, being humble, that you are manifesting this prayer energy. You're doing it with your humility, with your ability to work, with your ability to partner, and to be very present for your partner as they work through a very significant period of time in which happiness is growing for them, and probably some sort of contract, new work, new job that they're going to love is coming up. We see you, look at this, with all of these Aquarius planets. And I'm not going to go into great depth here, but what you have Aquarius energy in your Aquarius house of money. And the planet of abundance, Jupiter, is right here, hovering right now in the second house of earned income. We have Mercury, you could be signing a contract. We have Saturn, whatever you sign will be of duration for a long time. So you know, we're going to have Mercury retrograde momentarily. But if you've already begun a negotiation, feel safe to go forward. The sun is here. What we're seeing is that your second house of earned income, that which you produce, you are a rock star. So all of this hard work, the Virgo energy, is now paying off, and you are creating tremendous stability, tremendous abundance. And if it hasn't manifested yet, it's on its way. And with the Mercury retrograde, chances are you may have some idea what this is. But if when Mercury goes retrograde back and forth in your second house, it will pick up something that you may have dropped a long time ago as an idea, as an opportunity, even as somebody, a job you may have applied for, an investment of some sort that you made, and you may get news. That's what I'm seeing. News about that will be Mercury traveling backwards to pick up a thread somewhere in the past that you created, abundance that you created. So when we look at this beautiful energy of you and your partner is in the mode of nine of water. They bring you so much happiness, first of all. This is a happy place for you. Your partners, the two of you, are such good people. And what we see here with the nine of water is that your person has something to celebrate. The two of you will have something to celebrate that may have to do with a creative endeavor, a creative, whether they're a writer, whether they're an actor, whether they're a business person solving a problem. What we're seeing here is that your person has a big, big breakthrough moment. And here you are, you're the rock star of what you earn. You're being very enlightened, and you're approaching this in such an incredibly happy way that you and your partner are just pulling together as a team. Now, when we look at the energy of the Nine of Fire, you're working very hard. This could be local work. It could be communicative work. It could be producing something. You might be writing, a manual for a job at work. But when we look at the third house, we're looking at local travel. Communication, though, this is Gemini energy. And so you are probably working on something. You could be negotiating a contract, because when we get Capricorn here, it does have that energy of work. What we're also seeing is that you may be obsessed, and rightfully so, with the planet of money, Venus, beauty, love, with Pluto, which could be, some of you may be independent contractors who are landing some sort of a contract or an opportunity with maybe like a Fortune 500 company, because Pluto always is other people's money. So it means that you may be in a situation where you're getting to tap into, like it would be Fortune 500, you know, like I worked for United Airlines at one time. So it would be that sort of opportunity where you'd really get to have something that you enjoyed, that was invaluable, that would bring you money and wealth, and it would probably have to do with career. Now your lovely partner is able to stay at home at this time. It looks as though they're going to transition into some sort of work that deals with communication, messenger of earth. It's going to pay well. They're very grounded. Your partner is very, very grounded in their ability to do this, and it makes them incredibly happy. When we get to the fourth house, it does look as though you would like to move. Sagittarius says that you may be moving far away. Now, the Three of Air is that you may have some heartbreak with moving. You know, you may not really want to move, but, you know, it's time. And the Three of Air really speaks to the fact that although you could be disappointed, but you know, it's looking at things from a higher perspective, knowing that you may be moving someplace sunnier, you know, allowing the fire in your belly to take you into this direction. Now, your partner, again, is probably dealing with a creative, communicative sort of energy in their career. So when we look at your home front, you know, it looks as though you're a little unsettled there. There's a lot of coming and going. There's a lot of need for expansion at this time, but it is protected by Jupiter, the planet of good luck. So it feels awkward at this time, but, you know, just really be humble. You really will manage this energy very beautifully. Your partner is really whole. It's almost like they're locked in their office, right? They're locked in an office somewhere and you are missing them. They're very, very busy. And but there is something you want to change. You will change about your home life, and your partner looks as though once again, they're very comfortable being a hermit. And sometimes I think that interferes with your sense of belonging, you know, like you miss them and they could be right there with you in the same home, hermiting to work on a project. So when we look at your beautiful fifth house of romance, we're looking also at your house of friendship. You know, we're looking at the Hierophant card. Many of you would very much like to be married to your romantic partner. For some of you, you might be married, you know, of course. But right now, you have this beautiful, very stabilizing energy. You are working very hard to create this a beautiful life for you and a love interest. I believe that many of you live with your person. Some of you won't. Take it as it resonates. Whatever applies is yours. But we see you, Pisces, really following very traditional norms, trying to work on a romance and in hopes that your person will actually legalize that romance through the Justice card, which is, you know, of course, going from the fifth house to the seventh house of marriage. So you really would like to see them make a commitment. The Justice card indicates legal paperwork. It's Libra, you know, it's for you, it's Taurus energy, which the Hierophant is Taurus energy. And so in your 11th house of hopes and dreams, we have a lot of Taurus activity. You have Uranus, great changes that are coming into your world around you, things that you hoped for, things that you hope to manifest. Right now, Pisces, if you have a dream, again, about changing jobs, going independent, what we're seeing here is Spirit is saying, absolutely go for it. You will have financial stability. You will find it a very passionate way to live. It really is this a very strong ignite your passion fire guardian energy. Your partner is very balanced. We see them in a very good spot. We see this Taurus energy. So there have been many changes that have come to your friendships. You might actually be feeling as though you don't have enough friends, but we also get Mars. So something that came through your life recently has made a sudden change, you know, almost like a lightning bolt. And it does look like your partner may be signing a contract that's going to make them very happy, in which they will, you know, be writing, which is Gemini energy with the messenger energy, and they'll be working from home. All right. So let's look at your sixth house energy. Your sixth house is your day-to-day life. For you, Libra is resting on your sixth house. And what we're seeing here is that you need to make some adjustments. The King of Air says that you're bringing in this beautiful, enlightened energy. Again, I think you may be changing jobs soon. For those of you who are not actually changing jobs, I feel as though you're going to get a much more higher level of, you're going from the King of Air to rock star status. So I think that you will be sought after. For some of you, you may go, you know, you may work independently in a job that you're familiar with now. Now, when we look at your 12th house, your partner is sequestered away. What is the hidden energy here for you? Is it your partner is a fiery queen? Your partner is somebody that you absolutely delight in. that I have to move the table a little bit. Okay, there we go. Sorry about that, guys. I don't even know how it gets crooked. Okay, so we see this beautiful Queen of Fire energy, and the Queen of Fire is Aries energy. And it's a time when I feel as though for many of you, your partner is just, you know, they're lit right now. They're so happy. They're just, your time alone, it just feels so precious to you. And so that really brings, again, that fire element of passion. You are divinely protected. You are receiving the gifts of the universe. Jupiter and Saturn will be in your second house of earned income for quite a while. Saturn is here, and that's going to cause you to work hard. That's okay. Saturn's stability also. But you're going to become a rock star. And as we look at Jupiter, you have Jupiter here for a year off and on. And Jupiter will bring you lots of luck and abundance. Sending you love from Chicago, Pisces. This has been a joy. Thank you so very much. Take care. Bye-bye.